Hi, this is Jeremy85. I recently did a video on the steering problem of my 96 Dodge Ram 2-wheel drive. Thank you, RTT2083, for your comment. You are suggesting drop-down Pitman and idler arms, but in this video I would like to show you why I don't think that will work. It's a 2-wheel drive truck with independent front suspension. That being said, now, if you're driving this truck over a bump, the tire moves up and down, and so do the upper and lower control arms. But the wheel doesn't just move up and down. Since it's independent front suspension, the wheels move in and out as well, which means the distance between the two front tires changes while the suspension is doing its job. And that's why the tie rod ends need to be parallel to the lower control arm, so that they can do the same movement as the lower control arm. Now, if I would just go ahead and drop down the tie rod ends wouldn't be parallel to the lower control arm anymore, which would lead to a big steering problem with every movement of the lower control arm, meaning with every bump and with every pothole that you hit with the truck. Because as the distance between the two front tires changes during suspending, the steering tie rod ends wouldn't be able to do the same movement, and they will pull the front tires towards each other. I think that's why I've never seen drop down Pitman or idler arms for this 2-wheel drive truck model. And it's not that I haven't looked for it. Thank you again, RTT2083, for your idea, but so far I haven't found any drop down arms for this 2-wheel drive truck. If anyone watching this video has this kind of Fabtech suspension lift kit on this kind of truck, it would be really nice if you could give me a quick idea on how you solve the problem that the tie rod doesn't hit the sway bar while steering. Thank you very much for watching. I appreciate every comment. Jeremy85 signing out.